guys, what's up? It's Joe Rady from Rady's Rides. I'm here where they once filmed Days of Thunder. And guess what? We have a car that's bringing a lot of thunder. This is the 2019 Mazda MX-5, better known as the Miata RF. RF stands for Retractable Fastback. Let's talk a little bit about Mazda history before we get in this car. Mazda's been around since the 1920s. They first were developing cork, of all things. They didn't make their first car until the 1930s. It was called the Mazda Go. It was a three-wheeled pickup truck. Throughout the years, Mazda really made a niche for itself, especially when it came to the rotary engine. The rotary engine was synonymous with Mazda. They were the first Japanese car company to win the famed 24 Hours of Le Mans, and they did it with a rotary engine car. No other manufacturer has done that since, and that was all the way back in 1991. This car first came out, the Mazda Miata, all the way in 1989, if you could believe that. It really was a throwback to those early British sports cars. Two seats, light, not a lot of horsepower, but you know what? If you know how to drive, when the road gets twisty, they really pay back big dividends. The reason why those cars got so popular here in the United States after World War II was because all the GIs were coming back from Europe, got to taste some of that light, fun sports car excitement, and they were able to take it, and when I say they, Mazda, and really build a great product. Believe it or not, to this day, it's the number one selling sports car, two-seat sports car, Mazda Miata. It's gone through a few generations. This generation came about 2016, where things changed. Now, even though the car may look a little bigger than previous generations, it's actually only weighing 300 pounds more than the original. Think about how exciting that is with all the extra stuff that they have to put in cars now. But let's go ahead, dive into this 2019 Mazda MX-5 Miata RF, because guess what? There's some changes for 2019. As you see, when we jump right into it, featured in that Soul Red. Now, the Soul Red is an extra cost color, but I'm telling you, it's worth every penny. It's the only color like this for Mazda. When you see this, this is a Mazda-specific color. Such a great red, probably one of my favorite reds of all time. Now, for 2016, when they came out with this body style, this is that wonderful headlight shape. Really made the Miata kind of look more meanish in a good way. Full LED lighting. I like the way it's blacked out inside the housing, and you have adaptive headlights. That means when you turn the steering wheel, the lights also turn with the wheel. Think about the advantage at night. Now, this trim level of this one, you could have it one of three ways. You could have Sport, Club, or Grand Touring. This is the fully loaded Grand Touring model. With that, you're gonna get this lower lip spoiler down here. It's gonna help produce more downforce, and it's gonna help scoop air into that front radiator. I like the way they black out light smoke on the daytime running lamps, because those are LEDs behind there. When we come across the front, I love what they did with the front grill mouth area. You have horizontal slots here that are flat black, gonna help scoop air into that radiator. Nice low nose and just a great flow to it. As we go up onto the hood, look at the great body lines that go into the headlights and up onto that hood. It's going to give you such a great vantage point from behind the wheel. These two arches from the fenders allows you to hit those apexes with the greatest of ease. Now, as we come around the bend here, this is Grand Touring specific. These wheels are a 17-inch wheel. I like, it's like a almost like a gunmetal gray, dark chrome color. Very nicely done. You got Bridgestone Potenza tires. Very nice amount of space here. You're sitting on Bilstein dampeners, so you're going to get better suspension pieces with the Grand Touring and the Club. As we go into the fender area, I love what they did with the side marker light. Look at how they actually created a body line to put that perfectly placed. Love it. Down low, just like up front, you have the front lip spoiler. You also have the side sill extensions, and I love the way they kind of come out just far enough and then taper into the rear fender area. Doors, everything perfect. Now, this one being that RF, retractable fastback, you get the best of both worlds. You could have your hard top, but when you're ready to have fun in the sun, this goes away. So I really think it was smart the way they went gloss black, really blends in well with the rest of the rear of the car. I love this design flowing back towards the rear trunk area. Really, it shows that they didn't just slap this together. And remember, this Koju design, it's carved and molded from a single piece of clay. That's how they got to this design, not with fancy computer graphics and stuff. We come off the rear flared fenders. I love the way they flare out. You have the continuation of the side sill goes into your side skirt and just rubs around the bottom of the rear bumper. Twin exhaust. Now the exhaust has been updated. They're freer flowing because remember, underneath that hood, we have more horsepower for 2019. We'll get to that in a second. Love the sexy style of the taillights. Very Jaguar-esque, and I mean that in a good way. Full LED, MX-5 badge, a nice gloss black kick-up spoiler. My biggest zonk is gonna be this. Why do we have this if we have this shark fin antenna? Get rid of this and get all the technology in here. I do like the very low blends right in third brake light, and that rear glass just looks so sports car-esque. It really fits the car well. But why don't we go ahead, pop the hood, and see what's powering this Mazda Miata. All right, guys, we got the hood popped on the 2019 Mazda MX-5. I don't know if you noticed when we went around the outside, it doesn't say Miata anywhere on this vehicle. Now, new for 2019, if you got a 2018, it's not the same. You got your 2-liter inline four naturally aspirated engine. We now have 181 horsepower, 7,500 RPM redline. That is up from 155 horsepower. So we're not talking about two extra horsepower. We got three more pound-feet of torque. That brings us to 151 pound-feet of torque. You could have it your way. 6-speed manual that has revised gearing inside the gearbox, or you could get your 6-speed automatic. Even the RF with the folding hardtop weighs 2,444 pounds. That equates to a 0 to 60 of 5.8 seconds, quarter mile in 14.5 at 96 miles an hour, top speed 138 miles an hour. When it comes to MPGs, 26 in the city, 34 in the highway, think about it, 2,400 pounds, lightness. Yeah, it doesn't have a ton of horsepower. Yeah, you're not gonna be able to beat a Mustang at a stoplight when you're drag racing, but in the right hands on a twisty road, this thing is lethal. I love the engine. I think Mazda did a great job with the nice brushed aluminum cam cover there. You can see all the inner bits, very nicely done. This one has the optional, even has the Soul Red MX-5 oil cap. You can see the strut tower brace, the 3-piece strut tower brace, nicely done. And what I love about it is you see the engine. Front engine, rear wheel drive, just like a real sports car should be, because that really is the question in this video. Is this the best real sports car on the market? But why don't we go ahead, fire it up, and hear what 181 horsepower sounds like. All right, guys, time to get inside the Mazda Miata, that MX-5 RF. I know you're probably saying, Joe, this car looks like a ton of fun. I promise you it is. You love the Soul Red just like I do. How much is it? This one, the way it's optioned, Grand Touring trim. Remember, that's top trim with the RF, the retractable fastback. It's gonna be an MSRP around $37,000. Let's see what you get to the door panels. I love the leather on the very, very small armrest. It is small, but remember, this is a small car. You got leather on the back portion of the door panel with the red contrast stitching, and I love the way they take the outside body color and bring that Soul Red inside. One thing I would say as a zonk is I wish they would have made those armrests lift up and have some storage inside there, sort of like a Porsche 911. I think that was a missed opportunity, but very stylish door panel. Now, when we get to the dash, it is harder, even on the Grand Touring trim here, but you do have the simulated stitching, little softer material in this midsection. Now, one thing that's very smart is you have your circular air vent here with the brushed aluminum, very nicely done. You have another one here, but look at how smart the Mazda engineers were. They found some real estate for another air vent. So your passenger could have two, and then the driver yourself could have two. You have your infotainment system. It is touchscreen, and this one does have navigation. It's the older system, but you know what? I kind of like it. I think it's very easy to use, very easy to get to, and that's a very nice feature as I go back to home there. As we drop down on the Grand Touring, you get the silver trim around your traditional AC venting, start-stop, keyless entry, and all that good stuff. This little toggle switch I'll show you in a second is to make that hard top fold and go away. You have a nice little cubby area, two USBs, heated seats, but no ventilated seats. brushed aluminum finish here. This is the magic. Revised six-speed manual transmission for 2019. The throws are so wonderful, so mechanical, and I'm telling you, from second to third, it is a thing of beauty what they've done with this gearbox. You have your direct drive control knob for everything happening. If you don't want to touch the screen, if you're anti-touch and you rather twist the knob, you could do it this way. Select your navigation and whatnot. There we are, navigation. You have your volume button, good old-fashioned e-brake with leather, the red contrast stitching, a little softer armrest. It's still pretty hard. All of this is hard plastic, even on the Grand Touring. Open this up, you got enough room for about one Twinkie size, two cup holders. Now, what they did was is they redesigned how these lock in. They actually lock in a lot more efficiently with the newer setup on 2019. You also have a spot for your passenger up here if they want to have their drink a little closer to them, but we'll take that out. And it works really well. You have a glove compartment that you could put your wallet or whatever you need back in there. And then these seats, Grand Touring, full leather, speakers are in the headrest, you can see. Contrast stitching all the way down, very, very comfortable, very soft, and the bolstering is nothing that's gonna squeeze you very tight. This one also has, as Tom backs away, the optional side sills that are aluminum. Very nice touch, that is an option. Why don't you come on over to the business end though, and I'll show you behind the wheel of this Mazda Miata. All right guys, time to show off the top. This is a thing of beauty. It's really orchestrated well. That toggle switch I showed you earlier, you're actually gonna push up to make the top go down. Kind of backwards, but there it goes, folding away. You hold it down, you get an image of a Miata, a silver Miata, on your dash to let you know what's going on with the process. You hear a nice beep and it says operation complete and top is down. So you get that full open air feel. I'm 6 feet tall, even with the top up, plenty of headroom, perfect for putting on a helmet. Because remember, this car is meant to be not only a car to drive on the road and enjoy the twisties, but you could go do an autocross event or a track day event. I'm gonna have Tom back up a little bit. I wanna show you, new for 2019 is you have two-way positional doors. So what that means is when you open up the door, you have one position and that is the second one. If you're wondering, well, what did the other ones have? They had a three position door and a lot of owners didn't like that. So that's why Mazda said, hey, we're gonna give you what the owners want. Steering wheel, I wish it was a little thicker, but it's the perfect size. It doesn't need to be flat bottom. First time on a Miata is the steering wheel tilts and it telescopes. So that's all new for the first time. You have manual controls where you could actually adjust the pivot of the bottom of the seat, and also of course the back and sliding front to rear. This one has the optional aluminum pedals, perfect for heel toe. Look at this, heel toe all day long. It's even got the nice brushed aluminum pedal. That's an option for the dead pedal. And I'm telling you, 6 feet tall, I got plenty of room in here, which is surprising. The dashes set up perfectly. The dash is so perfect. You got the tach right smack dab in the center. Everything is analog. Now over on the far left is actual digital. So it looks like it's analog. It's showing that the door is open right now, but believe it or not, you could actually have different information that shows up there. And it's so clear that it looks like it's an analog gauge. I'm glad that they went round. There's so many cars that have a round fixture, but then they put a square screen in there. It doesn't make sense. Overall, placement is great. Here's another new thing, watch this. You put the car in reverse, first time on Miata, a backup camera. Now, the reason why they added the backup camera is that by law, all 2019 models must have a backup camera. So you do have a backup camera. It's non-directional, and it's kind of not the clearest of vision, but at least you have something. Because the problem is when driving, this beautiful design does give you a bit of a blind spot, whereas with the convertible top, you just throw it back and it's all open. But boy, does it look good. Let's go ahead though. Let me go ahead and let's check out the trunk and see how much space you have back there, even with the top down. All right guys, tail end of business. Now what's awesome is the engineers figured out a way so that when the top goes down, you don't lose any trunk space. You have the same amount of trunk space as the cloth folding convertible. One thing I wanna show you before we open up the trunk is you can see how the glass is totally gone between the driver and passenger. You got the little rollover hoop here, and this little deflector there is to help cut down on wind turbulence. Now to open up the trunk, if you're wondering, well, how do I do this? Right there's your button. opens up, same exact opening, same depth. You can see I have my backpack in here, my lunch bag, and there's still plenty of room in here. You could easily put two carry-ons in the back of this Miata RF and go enjoy a nice weekend getaway, especially somewhere in the mountains. Right now, I would like to go to North Carolina, go do the Dragon, Charola Skyway, and really have a good time. But let's get to the best part. Speaking of good time, let's get to the best part. Let's take this Mazda RF for a spin.
All right, guys, we're inside the 2019 Mazda Miata RF MX-5. We have the top up just because I wanted you to be able to hear me clear and really get a sense for the wind noise in here, even with the top up, because that's one thing that I've noticed is that the joints where the fold top actually does the folding, there is a bit of wind noise. But here's the best part. This is where the Miata just really shines in these turns. So even in this right-hand bend here, holds the line very well. Remember, we're in the Grand Touring. We're not in the club. On the brakes. Look at this transition right here. Look at this. This is great. Nice. Tail comes out just a little bit to let you square off the corner, but it really is a thing of magic. I'm in third gear, letting it pull. Remember, it goes all the way up to 7,500 RPM. You get great induction growl in here. Very nice. It's down to second. Nice. Really loving the sounds. That naturally aspirated engine just wants to scream and pull all the way to redline. It really sounds good, feels good, the throttle response is awesome, and the best part is with this car, you don't have to worry about putting in Sport, Sport Plus, you just get in, you drive. That's the best part. All right, guys, a little bit of an acceleration test from a dead stop, feathering the throttle, letting out clutch, here we go. To 60, 5.8 seconds, feels good. On the brakes, nice, look at this, here we go. This is what a Miata is all about, baby. Woo! Going on the highway is a breeze, even the smaller car. Now with the Grand Touring, you get blind spot monitoring, you get lane keep assist, emergency braking, all that good stuff. And the great news is with the hard top, if you've been worried about using a convertible every single day, this hardtop, the folding hardtop, allows you to drive this every day if you don't need a lot of room. The back storage, the back trunk area, I was gonna call it storage area, but the back trunk area, like I said, two carry-on bags. If you're not really needing to carry a lot in your car, I think it's just enough room, and the space inside feels good. Even with me being 6 feet tall, I still feel like I have plenty of room, which is great. Just really smooth. And you don't have to keep downshifting, which is great. I mean, I was in fourth gear, you roll back on the throttle and you're still in a good place. Down to third, here we go, let's go in this right-hand bend. Really nice, look at this, she holds a line great. Coming out of the turn, keep it in third, on the brakes. Really smooth, I love the way this thing just hugs the turns. Nice, throttle. Really, really good. Really good. She loves the twisties. And like I said, if you know what you're doing, this car is a ton of fun. That old school light sports car feel. Really nice. I love the induction growl. Now I will tell you, with the top down, there is a bit more turbulence in the cockpit rather than the convertible top, just because of the extra pieces of body work and whatnot. So that is the one thing to be aware of. I'm not gonna tell you everything is just peachy keen in this car. That would be a zonk is the amount of turbulence that you have. But overall, still that familiar, fun, great handling Miata that you know and love. All right, guys, here we go, one last time. Second gear, I'm gonna try second gear this whole thing. Really nice, the car is so balanced. It's so balanced, it just wants to just give, give, and give a little bit more. That's the great thing about it. And if you ever need to make a U-turn in a Miata, it's probably the easiest thing you'll ever do in your life behind a wheel. I mean, look at this. Great turning radius. Awesome turning radius. I love this car so much. Unbelievable. You don't need a ton of power. You really don't. It just gets you in trouble. This is it right here. Watch this. Very nice. That's what it's about. That's what it's about right there. Throttle feels great. Absolutely great. Guys, hopefully that gave you enough feeling, sensation of what the Mazda MX-5 Miata RF is all about. We're gonna go ahead, wrap this one up. I don't like ending these types of drives. The drive from this Miata is a blast, but like all good things must come to an end, so I'll see you back at our special location in a split second.
All right, guys, been another fun time with a Miata. I'm telling you, if you have not driven one at all or lately, you definitely need to get behind the wheel of either an MX-5 RF or the traditional standard MX-5. I definitely got to thank everybody at Mazda for allowing me to have access to this test vehicle. If these are the things you like to see, where we examine, is this the best sports car for the money currently on the market, true sports car, leave a comment in the comment section. If you're new to the channel and you're on your way out, hit that subscribe button. I promise you it's worthwhile coming back for more. If you are a subscriber, thank you for being part of the Radies Rise family. If you want to help us keep making great content just for you on the channel, click the link in the description, get yourself some merch. Speaking of getting some help, Tom Moschner's here, out here in the sun. He's loving this Miata. He took some photos. Check him out on Instagram, at Mosh Photos. Not only does he love cars, but he loves nature, women, and babies. So definitely check that out. Thank you, Tom, for all your hard work. And just like always, I'll see you on the next ride.